MSC tutvustas tarbeelektroonika messil CES uusi tooteid, mis sisaldavad autotööstuses tuntud HMI ehk Human Machine Interface liideseid. See tähendab, et on loodud uusi kohti ning vahendeid, millega kasutajale informatsiooni kuvatakse. Kuigi tegemist on alles test toodetega, tundub, et mõningas aja pärast võiksid sellistest lisades saada tavapraktikas pidevalt kasutusel olevad lahendused. Hetkel on lisatud HMI Aegis TI5 lauaarvutile ja monitorile MG381CQR. Mõlemad tooted peaksid müügile tulema selle aasta lõpuks.
This is our first HMI monitor. HMI stands for Human Machine Interface, which is a concept that originated from supercars. Now, the concept basically means that we want to streamline information to the users. We do that by the second front-facing OLED display on our monitor and this control dial. So right now it's displaying different hardware specs, cycling through different things and real-time notifications like weather. So this one, it has, you can control all the Mystic light from it. So as you can see, right now all the Mystic light is off. I'm gonna change it to rainbow. So it syncs between the monitor, the keyboard, and the desktop. Now, this one doesn't have game modes like the desktop does, but it has different macro keys as well. You can program different macro keys into the monitor and just use it on the fly. Now this monitor is a 38-inch monitor. It is running at 144Hz refresh rate, 1 millisecond, and it's running at a 3840 by 1600 resolution. It is an IPS panel that is GC compatible as well. It'll come out later this year, maybe Q3 or Q4. That's to be determined. So if we wanted to control it, we can spin and we can control Mystic light. So right now it's doing a breathing RGB, and when you click rainbow, it syncs all the devices that have Mystic light to it. Another one of the features that we have for the desktop is gaming profiles. So if you click on gaming mode, you can see it has a bunch of different presets for games. We can also open up the game from here. So if I wanted to open CSGO, I click it and it should open. And the last one right now is monitoring specs. But later down the line, we might have some more features.